Hello there. In this short video, I want to just touch one topic which might not be very popular among many adult chess players, improvers, and generally online chess players. And well, my point is that improvement is not a fun activity. So if you want to improve in chess, then you will not be able to improve if you only do the stuff that are fun. Well, before I start giving arguments for a disclaimer, let me just draw one parallel. So when I was in high school, I was part of the basketball team. I was playing basketball. And I met several different types of players. And there is one type of players who were very ambitious and who wanted to improve in basketball. So they wanted to play basketball on the high level and they wanted to become good players and improve in basketball, let's say like this. And these players, if you look what they did to improve, these activities were not fun activities. In fact, most of them were rather boring. For example, they went on jogging, they went to the gym, they spent a certain amount of time doing just these conditional exercises, which are not in any way fun. They are not connected to playing with the ball. And also, even in the when they did have a ball, they would usually spend hours on just learning fundamentals. So just doing basic fundamental exercises over and over again ad nauseam. For example, they would take the ball and shoot at the hoop for several hours. So it's not a fun activity. I mean, it's fun to shoot. Okay, Coco. It's fun to shoot on the hook several times, but to take a ball and shoot from the distance of say 3 meters on the hoop and do this several hours in a row can be pretty boring. And in fact, it is this mentality and this hard work which eventually distinguished these players from the players who just played for fun. I mean, they didn't just play for fun, but they preferred fun over hard work. And that means, for example, that they would play lots of street ball. So there is nothing more fun in basketball than playing 3-on-3 on the street. So this is what they did mostly, and they enjoyed you know, showing off on the street and playing basketball. And instead of investing their time in fundamentals, so in conditional trainings, in gym, in jogging, and in just doing repeatedly all the fundamental stuff you need to know to play basketball, they would rather choose to spend this time playing streetball. And after a few years, you can see that these players who did boring stuff, they improved, and these players who were playing lots of basketball just for fun, usually didn't improve in the sense in that they started to play a real basketball on a higher level. Maybe, but there is one subtlety. Maybe they are even better. They became better streetball players than the hard workers. But they didn't become better basketball players if you look at real basketball, 5-on-5 on two hoops and so on. So this is the comparison. And now if you transpose this to chess, you can also see that there are two types of chess enthusiasts, chess players. One type is the type who is seeking for fun, who wants to play chess for fun and who wants to spend their chess time enjoying themselves, just. And those players usually play lots of bullet, they play lots of blitz, they hardly ever play longer games. Or if they watch some materials, then it's usually these kind of YouTube channels which are entertaining. So, you know, there are these YouTube channels with chess content which are entertaining, and it's much fun to watch them, and it's and they don't require much intellectual effort or hard work. You just run the YouTube, you watch and you enjoy. And okay, even if these kind of videos, you are exposing yourself to chess, so there could be some improvement benefits, but not much. This time should be spent much better. So The other type of players, which I think I'm that kind of the example of that kind of player, is the players who wants to improve in and who wants to grow in the understanding of chess. And for example, I can speak for myself. So my ambition is to understand the game of chess better and to play real chess. When I say real chess, I am talking about over the board slow times control chess. So I want to play real chess, I want to understand the game of chess better, and I want to be able, when I watch, for example, candidates tournament, that I have this understanding that I can understand at least some of moves and ideas which grandmasters play, and also that I can enjoy when I go through master games, that I can enjoy it by understanding the game and the ideas. So in order to do this, if you want to improve, if your ambition is to get a better understanding of chess, then you don't have time for fun activities. And this is what I mean when I say improvement is not fun. For example, if you can spend 1 hour or 2 hours a day on chess, then you cannot afford to spend this time by playing Blitz Bullet or watching entertaining chess videos. Instead, you need to spend this time on doing stuff you have to do. Either you feel like it or you don't feel like it. Because if you don't overcome this barrier, okay, I will now do things which I know I have to do even though I don't feel like it. If you don't go through this barrier, then you will never improve. So if you're only doing the things you feel like doing, you will most likely not achieve serious improvement. For example, if you see that your end games are very weak and you objectively, either by yourself or by the help of your coach or colleague, it doesn't matter, but you objectively come to the conclusion that you have to work on your end games in order to improve, then you should work on your end games. And this could be boring, this could be hard work, this could be difficult, and you might not feel like doing this, but you still have to do this if you want to improve. Or you can just go and play Bullet and stay on your level all the time. So in order to improve, you need to have discipline, you need to have dedication, you need to know what you should be doing on, or at least have a very good guess of what is the things you should be doing on, and then just do it. It doesn't matter if this is boring, if you don't feel like this, if you don't have fun. It's not your goal to have fun, it's your goal to improve in chess. And then you will get your reward after you improve in chess, after you gain higher understanding of chess, then you will enjoy your chess games more, you will enjoy watching master plays, and this will be your reward. And not this instant gratification which you get just by playing Blitz Bullet and watching entertaining YouTube videos. So this was my point, and this is also a philosophy which I try to imply on myself. So when I choose what will I do next and how will I train chess, then I try to see objectively what is the need for me on this level, what are my weaknesses and what should I be working on. So for example, I started when I saw that my calculation and the basic tactics, basic board vision was bad, I started to do Polgar chess book. Polgar chess book is mostly mate in two. So I did like maybe 1500 mate in two, 1500 mate in two problems I solved. And okay, then I stopped because I realized, okay, this is enough for this. So it wasn't always fun. So mate in two is sometimes fun. But if you are doing 1500 mate in two problems, you can realize that there will be times which you don't feel like doing this or it's not so fun, but you know that you have to do this. And this is like when also when you decide to read a book. So if you come to conclusion, for example, that your opening strategy is not good, that you do not have right ideas how to apply basic opening principles in openings, you might want to check out Helston book opening strategy. And once you get this book, you have to read it from cover to cover. And usually it goes, when you take a new book, usually it goes like, okay, introduction is fun, then first chapter is interesting because it's a new style, a new kind of book, new fonts, new diagrams, and everything. And then after first chapter, well, the second chapter already becomes a little bit boring. Boring in the sense that you are not having fun and you have to invest hard work in doing this. But you have to go through the end, because you will not improve. Also, when doing tactics, are not easy if they are difficult. So if you are doing basic tactics, if you are learning patterns, well, it's kind of fun because you are solving within 10 seconds. You don't need to think a lot. Then you take your mouse, you try to visualize, to recognize the pattern, and you immediately play the move. But if you are training higher tactics on a higher level, which requires a calculation, that means that once you see the tactics in front of you, you should not touch your mouse or your pieces if you are doing on the board, but you should stop, think, and calculate all, see the candidate moves, see how would variations go, what are his best responses, and so on. And it is a difficult, hard work, and you don't always feel like doing this. Many times you will rather play blitz than doing this hard work calculation, but again, this is what you have to do if you want to improve. So this is I wanted to tell you, because I see lots of advices out there. You know, chess is supposed to be fun. If you don't feel like doing something, then don't do this. Do only stuff you feel like doing, and so on. And I think these advices are wrong, because you should be doing what you should be doing, not what you feel like doing or you find fun to do. And well, I mentioned before, you can see this Yusuf of books, so I'm applying this to my current training plan. So I came to conclusion that I have many holes in my knowledge. So I know lots of stuff about different aspects of chess, but from time to time, I see myself not being familiar with some elementary concepts which I should be familiar with. And the Yusuf of books are great because they fill you these holes. So Yusupov goes over everything. He goes end games, openings, middle game, strategy, tactics, everything. And if you read the Yusupov books, then you will fill your holes. And even though if you're a strong player, if you know 80% of the stuff Yusupov is talking about, still you will run this 20% you don't know. So my dedication for now is to go through Yusupov books. I made a video about this. I can link it below. And well, if you want this, if you watch this other video and you see what kind of books are that, then you can imagine that it's not always fun. And you have to read a theoretical introduction. You have to play all variations on the board. This can be difficult, and then you have to solve 12 puzzles by your own and write down the solutions. So I imagine that playing bullet chess is much more fun than that. But I will not repeat myself anymore. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you'll find the advice useful. And, well, please leave the comment below, click the like button, subscribe to my channel if you didn't, and see you very soon with more chess. Cheers.